God bless you, and it's good to see you again here this morning. And the study that we're doing is our book, Who Am I? The New Creation in Christ Jesus.
我们讲的就是这本书, 我是谁? 所以基督里面一个新造的人。
And as we read in the scripture, all things have passed away, and behold, all things are new.
就我们昨天也读到了那样的经文, 所有的旧我, 所有的过去都过去了, 然后我们就是新造的。
And what we have to realize is we have a memory of the past.
我们需要意识到的是, 我们对过去还有着一种记忆。
But when we confess our sins to God,
就是当我们向耶稣向上帝来认罪的时候,
and we ask Him to forgive us,
我们祈求他来原谅我们的罪,
He forgives us straight away.
他就很直接地原谅了我们。
And He removes from any record in heaven our sins.
他就把以前我们所犯的那些罪作为一种记录一样的全部抹去了。
So they're not accounted to us anymore.
这些罪就不会不再在我们的身上了。
Therefore, we are righteous.
这样的话我们就可以称义。
Now, if we're looking at the Chinese word for righteous,
就如果我们来看中文的这个汉字义这个字,
the two parts of that word,
这个字分为两个部分。
The top part is 羔羊。
那个义字的上面那个部分是一个羊,羔羊的羊。
And the bottom part is 我。
而下面那一部分是我。
So if I am under the Lamb,
我在羔羊之下,
I am righteous.
那么我就是称义的。
Now that's the way God sees us.
这就是上帝怎样来看待我们。
We struggle with that.
我们也内心有一些挣扎对于这些东西。
Because our mind keeps telling us of our past.
因为我们的思维一直在告诉我们那些过去的事。
But it's like having a computer that has a bad program.
就像一个电脑，它当中有一个不好的程序。
We need to reprogram the computer.
我们就需要来更新这台电脑。
And we need to put the information in.
我们就要把这些信息放进去。
And as we looked at yesterday, we know that we put the information in by studying the Word of God.
我们昨天就已经学到，这些新的信息就是从学习神的话语而来的。
By accepting that this is the truth,
来接受这个真理,
our thinking can be adjusted.
我们的思维就会被一种，就会得到一种审判。
Our attitudes can be changed.
我们的态度就会改变。
And our behaviors will follow that.
我们的这些行为也会跟着改变。
See, the Bible says, we are seated in heaven.
就是圣经当中说，我们就是已经坐在了天堂上。
You can see me here.
你可以看见我在这儿，这是真的。This
is our literal state.
这是我们,
is our literal position.
这是我们在这个自然的一个合法的位置。It
is actually, that's truth.
这也是真的。The
truth, the Bible says we are seated in heaven.
而真理就是说，圣经说我们就是在天堂。
Now, remembering yesterday, reason will fight against, human reason will fight against the Word of God.
就是人类的这个理性思维和推理，就是对，跟上帝就是一个对抗。
There are many people that have come to this church.
有很多人来到这个教会。
And they have enjoyed the presence of God.
他们很享受神给予的这个礼物。
They know it's special.
他知道这是很特别的,
but in their mind,
但是在他们思维上,
they have been taught Darwinism, evolution.
他就是在这个思维上却接受了这个达尔文的教导，就是这个进化论的教育。
And they find it hard to accept the things of God.
他就会觉得是很难接受上帝这么一说的。
But in the end,
但是最终,
they have to choose whether they follow the God of reasoning, of thinking, the God of thinking, or the God that we follow.
他是来跟随这个理性推理的这个神，还是我们所相信的这个上帝。
They place more faith in science than in the Word of God.
他们就是花了太多的那种科学的东西，而不是来跟随这个圣经。
But science is only verifying that the Word of God is the truth.
而科学能够证明圣经的话语就是真的。
There's good science.
这是一个很好的科学。
And there's bad science.
还有坏的科学。
The good science means that you can prove certain things.
好的科学就是用来，就是你可以用它来证明一些东西。
Bad science is when you cannot prove it, you just have an idea.
而坏的科学就是当你不能证明什么东西的时候，你只是运用着一种想象。
And so we need to understand that our faith is based on a belief in God, Jesus Christ, the Word.
我们的信仰就是基于耶稣基督，基于他的话语，神的话语。
This gives us our legal right.
这些东西就给了我们一种合法的权利。
If the devil is playing with your thoughts, if the devil is playing with your thoughts,
如果撒旦就是来玩弄你的这些思想的时候，
the word of God will settle the fight.
而神的话语才可以解决这样的一个征战。
Because it is our thoughts.
一方面是我们的想法。
The devil.
然后就有。
And there's fighting.
然后就有这些撒旦，然后就互相的抗争。
These two are fighting.
他们两个就打架了。
You can stop them from fighting.
你可以阻止他们的这种征战吗？
By this.
就是用圣经的话语。
Just picking up the word of God and starting to read.
就是拿起来圣经，然后开始。
Many people have contacted me and said, I am struggling with some thoughts or voices. I'm struggling with boyfriend, girlfriend. I'm struggling with my husband, my wife.
就是很多人跟他联系说他在和一些思想抗争，在和男朋友、女朋友、妻子或丈夫有一些抗争。
And I open up the Bible and say, read these scriptures.
然后他就会把圣经当中的经文一些章节分享给那些人。
And remember them.
然后让他们读，让他们记住这些。
So that you can speak them.
然后你就可以对他们说一些话。
The new creation in Christ.
在耶稣里新造的人。
Is a legal position.
就是一个就有拥有一个合法的地位，合法的位置。
It does amazing miracle.
他就能够完成一种 做到一种神迹。
It starts to change our literal position.
他就开始来改变我们在这个自然当中的一个位置。
Now before we start chapter 2 of this book.
当我们开始学习这个书。
I just want you to look at 7 important points.
就希望你们来明白七个重要的点。
Now, the believer.
就是一个信徒。
Is you and I.
就是你和我。
And so, when we are satisfied, when we have achieved great things in God,
我们有感到很满足的时候，
the believer is happy to know the word of God.
一个信徒是非常开心和喜悦来听到、知道神的话语的。
In knowing the word of God, you become strong.
来读懂神的话语的话，你会变得越来越强壮。
I used to go to the gymnasium and lift weights every day.
当他去那个
every day.
健身房吗？
The only way to get strong is to lift more and more every day.
就是变得越来越强壮。那么
When you stay in the Word of God, you will be happy.
当你学习神的话语的时候，你都会非常的开心。
Number two.The believer is happy to study the word of God.
第二个是学习圣经，那么也会很喜悦。
Now many people become Christians.
很多人成为基督徒。
Many people go to church.
很多人来到教会。
But sadly,
但是很不好的是
many of them do not read their Bible.
很多人他们不读圣经的。
They wait for the pastor to read the teaching and teach them what the Bible says.
他们就是等着这个牧师来给他们读圣经，教导圣经。
That's good.
这也很好。
But that's only a little bit.
但是这只是一点点。
What happens if the pastor is not telling the truth?
那么如果这个牧师讲的不是最真实的呢？
The people can learn some bad things.
那么这些人就会学到一些不好的东西。
And think that's what's in the Bible.
但这些东西却在圣经当中的。
You can read your Bible every morning.
你可以每天早上读圣经。
Or every night.
或者每天晚上。
Or at lunchtime, whenever you get a chance to read it.
或者在中午，就是任何你想要读的时候。
For me, I put a recording on and put it under my pillow so I could listen to it as I am lying in bed.
Wow, 他就是录了一个音，然后把它放在枕头边，每次可以听。
I have it on the iPad.
他放在了那个 iPad 上面。
I have a little iPad. I put it under my pillow and I can hear the word of God.
他就把那 iPad 里面装了这个声音版的有毒的这种，他就放在枕头边上听。
Now, that's good.
这都很好。
But there's something better.
但是还有更好的。
When you study the word.
就是当你来学习圣经。
Because when you study the word.
当你来学习。
You are answering a question that's in your own heart.
那么就是你来通过这样的方式解答你心中的疑惑。
Because you study the word to find an answer.
你就是来通过这种学习来解决这些问题。
Like a good detective.
就像一个好的侦探。
And he comes into a criminal scene. He has to solve the mystery.
他就是侦探，就是来解决这种谜团。
So when we read the word of God, we might see something that is mysterious.
就是当我们读圣经当中有些东西，会觉得好神秘的。
So as we study it,
所以我们来学习。
We start to understand why we believe something.
那么我们就是来学习为什么我们来开始相信一些东西。
I remember when I became a Christian.
我还记得当我刚刚成为基督徒的时候。
And the preaching was, you are saved by the blood of the Lamb.
然后那个牧师就说你被耶稣的宝血所拯救。
And they showed that, that the cleansing or the atonement means washing with the blood.Is an atonement.
就是一个约。
Our sins have washed away.
我们的罪就被洗净。
Now in the Old Testament.
在圣经当中旧约。
In the book of Leviticus, the law.
在那个利未记。
It says that our sins have been washed away.
就是说我们的罪被洗净了。
The only thing that can pay for it is blood.
那么就是用所有的代价就是这个宝血。
So I learned that lesson very quick.
我学那个课的时候非常的快。
And so I was happy that I was saved at the cross of Jesus.
那么他非常的开心，因为他因为耶稣被钉死十字架，他得到了救赎。
And then one day.
然后有一天。
Someone said in the church.
有人在教会当中说。
Ah, you should be water baptized.
你对这个受水洗确定吗
？To wash your sins away.
这个受水洗就是来洗净你的罪。
And then I became confused.
然后这一刻他就觉得很疑惑。
I said, isn't the blood to wash away the sins?
他就说，那不是耶稣基督的宝血来洗净我们的罪了吗
？And they said, oh, but the water also.
然后这个水也是洗净我们的罪。
I started to study the word of God.
然后他就开始学习神的话语。
To find out why there was a conflict.
他就来找出为什么这有一个争端。
What I found out.
然后他找到了。
And I don't have enough time to explain all of the biblical, all of the Bible references.
他就是没法解释所有这个圣经与之相关的这些内容。
But we will do it in another lesson on baptism.
但是我们会在另外一课讲这个受水洗、受洗的这个课里面讲到这些东西的。
What I found out from the Bible is we are saved by, we are cleaned of sins.By the blood of Jesus and saved by His calling on Him for forgiveness.
就是我们就是被耶稣基督的宝血所洗净的罪。
And when we get water baptized, which is an important thing.
当我们受水洗，这也是非常重要的。
The evidence in the Bible is that people started in ministry.
那么就是在圣经当中，这就是人们开始服事的证据。
The water does not have power to wash sins away.
水并没有洗净罪的这个能力。
But I don't have enough time to explain it all.
我没有足够的时间来解释所有的这些。
My main emphasis is. You need to study what is taught.
我想要强调的就是，你需要学习你所教导的东西，你也要去学习。
A good student
一个好的学生
has a notebook
有一个笔记本
and a pen
然后有一支笔
their Bible open
然后打开圣经
and they should be making records of things that are said
然后来记录这些圣经当中所说的东西
If I say something
如果我说一些内容
that doesn't feel right
那么感觉好像不是很对
Don't come to me and say,That doesn't feel right.
不要对我说这感觉不对。
Go home.
回家。
Read your Bible.
来读圣经。
Come back.
然后再回来。
And explain to me why I am not right.
向我解释我为什么不对。
Using the Bible.
用圣经的话语。
Explaining it from the Bible.
来解释它。
That means you need to name the book you are reading and the verse.
你要说出 你读的是哪本书然后读了哪 哪一个章节
Because if you feel one thing
如果你感觉一个东西
And I feel another thing
那我感觉另一个东西
We will end up fighting
我们就会有一个冲突
But if we use the word of God
但是如果我们用神的话
The word of God will settle it
神的话语就能解决这一切的冲突
And maybe I can learn something
可能是我也还能学到很多的东西呢
But the word of God is going to challenge you.
但是神的话语也在挑战着你。
Because it's going to change you.
因为它将要改变你。
So we should study the word of God.
我们就要来学习圣经。
Number three.
第三点。
In studying the word of God, we should be secure in the knowledge of where we are in God.
第三点就是在认识到在上帝那里的地位，并且以为之所感到一种安全感。
Can you say with a sure heart that you are a son or daughter of God?
就是你们心中会有一种相信，就是很确信，我们就是上帝的儿女。
That is the question. Are you sure of that knowledge?
这个问题就是你是否确信这个知识呢？这个点呢
？I know.
我知道。
I know.
我知道
I know.
我知道
Because I have this sure feeling.
我有这个很确定的感觉
Sure knowledge.
很确定的这个相信
That the word of God says this.
圣经当中的话语就说了这些东西
The believer is productive.
就是这些信徒都会有所成就
In all areas of life.
在所有的领域，生命当中所有的领域都会有所成就。
In some areas, we are really good at working.
在某些领域，我们会做得非常棒。
But when we study the Word of God,
当我们学习神的话语
，when we're sure in God,
当我们确信这一切
，we are very sure.
我们很确信。
We can venture and do other things.
我们可以做很多其他的事情。
I'm learning things every single day.
我每一天都学习。
I never knew how to use a computer.
我之前不知道怎么用电脑。
Until I came to China.
直到他来到中国。
Now.
而现在。
I do lots of different things.
我用电脑做了很多很多的事。
I make mistakes.
我有一个小错误。
I lose files.I lose some things.
他昨天就失去了一些文件。
They're in that computer somewhere.
就他在电脑中的某个地方。
And I pray to God.
他就向神祷告。
Help me.
帮助我。
And I become productive. I'm able to do more.
我要做更多。
Now we run this Bible college.
然后我们有了这个圣经的课程。
On the internet,
在网络上
and we are in 22 countries.
我们在二十个不同的国家都有
We have over 300 students graduating this year.
我们在今年又会有三位学生毕业
Most of these are pastors.
他们中大多数都会成为牧师
So they have something like 40 to 50 people in their church.
他们就会有三四十个人在他们的教会
So the teaching is going through the internet.Into these different countries,
这些课程就会在这些不同的国家传播。
We become more productive.
我们就会更加的有所成就。
Last night I got a letter from Thailand.
昨天他在泰有一个泰国的朋友给他写了封信。
And two people want to study from there.
两个有两位学生在那儿想要学习。
So there's another country.
这又是一个不同的国家了。
Maybe one day you will be going to those countries and you will be doing the teaching.
或许有一天你们会来到这些国家，然后你来讲，你来教导。
Touching many people.
来感动很多的人。
Because many years ago I prayed to God.
因为很多年之前他向上帝我向上帝祷告
because that year I had visited India and a place called PNG Papua New Guinea I went to two countries
他在那一年去到了印度和那个
PNG just near Australia
PNG 就是在澳大利亚附近的一个国家巴布吉
and I saw nearly 5,000 people become Christians
他看到了差不多有五千人来归向耶稣。
I saw miracles.
他看到了这样的神迹。
I saw people get set free from prison. Literally.
他看到人们就是得到了这样的释放。
And I said to God, Yeah.
他就对神说 ，Yeah.
I want to do more.
我想要做的更多。
And then, one or two months later, I was praying and said, God, I want to see more people saved.
那么他就向神祷告。一两个月之后，向神祷告说：“我想要看到更多的人得救。”
See, I want to be an evangelist.
我想要成为一个传福音者。
Go around and get people saved.
去让人们得救。
And then leave it to other people to be the pastor.
然后让更多的人成为牧师。
And I prayed to God. I said, "How can I be more effective?"
他就说我他向神祷告说：“我怎么来变得是做这些事情更有效率呢
？”How can I do more?
我怎么能做到更多呢？
He said to me,
他就是对我说
teach,
去教导
teach my words,
教导我的话语
And since we've been teaching his word, many people have become saved.
就是当他来教导这些话语的时候，越来越多的人得救
Many people are going out and leading churches.
越来越多的人，然后有了自己的教会
So therefore we are more multiplied.
然后我们就变得越来越丰富
Spiritually,
更有动力。
更有动力。
Spiritually, you are my spiritual children.
在灵里面，你们是我属灵的孩子。
When you start your own church,
当我们拥有我们自己的教会的时
候 people will be your children.
这些你教会的人就会成为你属灵的孩子。
And I will be a grandfather.
他就是属灵的爷爷祖父。
So maybe I'm in the faith of God. Maybe I'm a great 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 grandfather to some people.
然后就是他将来也可能会是很多很多人的那个祖。
But all to the glory of the Lord Jesus Christ.
但这些都是神的荣耀。
Because he is our Father.
因为他就是我们的父。
He is the one that started all of this.
他是所有一切的创造者。
He is the teacher.
他就是这个老师。
It's an important thing for you to study the word, become.More productive.
就是学习这样的话语，我们才能变得能做更多的事，更有能力。
When I first believed,
当他开始初信的时候
，I knew a very little.
他知道的只有一点点。
Now I have a doctor's degree.
但是他现在有了博士的学位。
And maybe you might say it's a piece of paper.
也许你们会觉得这不就是一张纸
？And that's all it is.
但是这就是一切。
But the good side of it, the really good side of it, is I had to study.
这最好的一点就是他能够学习。
I had to be disciplined. I had to discipline myself to do so much study every day.
他每天就是要自律做很多的事情。
I learned to be more productive.
他想要变得更加的有所成就。
So when I finish one thing, I go on to another thing. I have a plan to follow.
他做一件事，然后完成做下件事，他就会有一个计划。
You will become more productive.
我们也可以变得更加的多产，就是做很多的工。
Whether it's in teaching,
不论是在教导
，engineering,
在是工程方面
，accounting, whatever, you will become more productive.
就是在做会计啊，或者什么各种方面，我们都可以是有所成就的。
If you study the word of God,
如果你来学习神的话语
If you stay in Christ.
如果你与神同在。
If you're too busy.
如果你很忙。
With your work.
你很忙于你的工作。
To study the word of God.
而不能来学习神的话语。
You are too busy.
那么你就是很忙。
Okay. If I don't have time to go fishing.
如果我没有时间去钓鱼。
Then I'm too busy.
那我就是很忙。
I need to find time.
我需要找寻更多的时间了。
The believer is protected in all things.
就是在我们这些信徒是在任何情况下都受到保护的。
See, once we know our legal position, we are protected.
就是我们知道我们的这个法律的地位的话，我们就是被保护的。
Do you know the devil does not like you?
你知道吗？那些魔鬼撒旦是不喜欢我们的。
And he will try to upset you.
他试图想要让你感到很沮丧。
But he cannot stop you.
但是他却无法阻止你。
Because we have a victory in Jesus Christ.
因为我们与耶稣已经有着一个这样的得胜。
He would just be like a bump on the road.
嗯，他就是。
You know, like a bump. You're just driving the car and you.Hit a bump, you go boom, and come over the bump.
它就是一路上的一些小的障碍而已。
Not a mountain.
而不是一座山。
Just a little bump.
它就是路上的一个小障碍。
Because you know your legal position.
因为你知道你那个合法的地位。
You are a son and daughter of God.
我们是上帝的儿女。
You will prosper in everything you do.
我们做的任何事情都会很兴旺，很顺利。
Prosper means you will increase.
嗯，这个丰盛就是说我们会一步一步的长进。
People say to me, "Oh, I want a job where I can be the international manager of a company."
有些人说我想要一个这个工作，我想做一个去到一个国际化的大公司里面。
They haven't even graduated from college.
嗯，他才可能才从大学毕业。
He has planned our life.
他计划着我们的人生。
We just have to seek him for advice.
我们首先就是要去寻求他。
But he will make us happy and we will prosper.
嗯，他会让我们感到很喜乐，然后我们的生命也变得很丰盛。
My biggest weakness in life.
我生命中最大的一个弱点。
Is writing.
就是写作。
I've always been afraid.
他以前很惧怕这些东西。
I'm telling you something that is.Haunted me from a child.
就是在他小的时候，就这些东西困扰着他。
But today,
但是在今天
I've written 16 books.
他已经写了16本书了。
Before I was a Christian, no way.
在他成为基督徒之前，这是完全不可能的。
I didn't write even half a page.
他可能甚至连半张纸的内容都没写过。
I didn't want people to read it and see my mistakes.
他不想让人们来看到他的那个有些错误呀什么的。
You open my book now.
但是当你现在再打开它，
and you might find some mistakes.
你可能会发现一些小错误。
I don't really care.
但是他却不在乎了。
Because it is the message of the book that is important.
就是这本书所带给大家的这个信息是最重要的。
Overcome the fear of making mistakes.
就是他战胜了这个恐惧，这个可能犯错、害怕犯错的这个恐惧。
But if you email me and tell me where I made a mistake, I will change it in the book and I will say thank you for helping.
但是当你如果发现书中的错误，然后以邮件的形式告诉他的话，他会非常开心，也感谢你告诉他这样的错误。
God prospers us.
神上帝是来丰富我们、丰盛我们。
He will take your weakness.
他会带走你的这个软弱。
And he will make it a strength.
他会把这些软弱变成你的强壮，你的强项。
So when God said to me, "Stop writing,"
当神对他说你要开始写作了
，I mean, wow.
他觉得很惊讶。
He said, "Write the teaching down."
他就是说要你把你所教导的内容写下来。
I started to think of my fear.
他就想到了他的这种恐惧。
But the word of God said,
但神的话语说
to me, "You can do all things."
在我你能做任何事
through Christ
就是通过耶稣基督
who strengthens you
他会给你力量
I can do all things
那么我就能做任何的事
情。That God asked me to do.
神让我所做的。
Through Christ.
通过耶稣基督所做的。
So I pray. I say, Lord, what is it you want me to write?
然后他就祷告，然后说神要我来写作。
One night I was praying to God, and I said, "What do you want me to do?"
有一天晚上，他向神祷告说，上帝，你要我做什么呢？
I'm available. I am available. What would you like me to do?
我就是很乐意的让你要我做什么，我都会很乐意。
I give myself afresh to you. I give myself again. If you want to use me, use me.
我就是把自己完全的摆在你的面前，你想要怎么用我，你就怎么用我。
He didn't say a thing.
他没有说什么。
I fell asleep.
然后他睡着了。
And I slept very quietly and soundly all night.
睡得很香。
I woke up in the morning.
早上的时候醒来。
And I had a sentence.
他早上醒的时候，
脑
海里就会有一个句子，有
just three words.
有三个词。
Rite of passage.
就是要来写。
And I thought, what does that mean?
然后他说这是什么意思啊？
I can never remember seeing it. So I wrote it down.
然后他把那个写下来。
I did a search.
他就在找。
I found out what it meant.
他想找那是什么意思。
3 months later.
3个月之后。
I had finished a draft for one of my books.
他就结束了，完成了他的第一本书。
See, God can make us prosper.
上帝就是能让我们变得丰
盛。Be productive.
来变得有所成就。
If we are available.
如果我们是愿意的。
Are you available to God? Available. So God can use you anytime.
如果我们是有价值的，那么上帝就会来使用我们。
We will be secure. We will be sure of our home.
我们是很确信我们的这个家的。
So even though we have a journey or a road to do in our working life,
就是那么，即使我们是有一个这个旅途和这样一条长长的道路。
One day, we will die.
最终有一天我们会离世。
At the end of our Life's journey.
就是在我们人生旅途中就会有一个终结。
And we know we will be in heaven with Him.
然后在我们离开的那一刻，我们会知道我们已经归到天家，在天堂。
And I think those 7 points are really important.
我觉得这七点是非常重要的。
That finishes off from the lesson we were doing yesterday.
这就是我们昨天所学的最后的一些内容。
So I just want to thank you.
就是非常的感谢大家。
For listening to this lesson.
来听这个课。
And that you will be secure.
那么我们就能够确信。
You will feel safe.
我们得到了这样的救赎。
In the knowledge that you are in Christ.
然后我们就明确的知道我们与耶稣是同在。
In our next lesson,
在我们的下一课
we're going to look at the attributes of God.
我们会来读到上帝的属性。
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
非常感谢大家。